Hey guys, how's it going? Happy, gosh, it feels like Monday, and this is how sad it is, how fast my days go. I got back from Portland on Sunday night. It's Wednesday. It feels like Monday. It feels like I just got back from my trip. Cheers to you. I'm gonna make a for my The Universe Knows mug, which is kind of appropriate, the follow your heart thing. I wrote my last blog post kind of about, I had a lot of conversations while I was out at Fitbloggin with several different people, and it was kind of like a bit of this conversation, a bit of that, overhearing this, overhearing that, and it was just this theme that made me feel necessary to write a blog post about this, which is too many people are either trying to be somebody else, feeling that they have to be somebody else or act like somebody else or do what other people do in order to be accepted or in order to find success. And that's exactly how you don't do it, in my opinion. Until you can truly, there's kind of two things here. You can't really be happy. This is a personal thing. You cannot be happy if you think that your happiness depends on other things. If you think that your happiness depends on things or a person or a job or a certain level of income, you're out of your mind. Because I can guarantee you, and I'm telling you, these are lessons I've learned over a long time. Still going to be learning these lessons. I don't care how much money you make. If you're entry-level worker, if you're making millions, every single person I know, if you ask them, are they happy with their earning? Unless they're at a true state of zen. Most people are gonna go, well, you know, I'd really like to make X amount more. Everybody always feels the next level up is not enough. And when you get to the next level up, they're already thinking about the next level up, okay? You've gotta get happy where you are regardless. And I can tell you this, as much as I spend a hell of a lot of time on Pinterest and I love buying things like coffee mugs and going into Pottery Barn, there's a lot of things I like, but I'll tell you this right now. I don't need anything else. I have a car that works. I have a great roof over my head. I have a condo that is furnished beautifully. There's a lot of stuff I haven't bought new in a while. I don't need anything. I have clothes, I have friends, I have family, and more importantly, I'm happy with myself, by myself. I don't get up and go, oh, I'm only gonna be happy if, you know, this happens today, or I'm only going to be peaceful if that happens today, or if that person says this to me, or if I close that business deal. You can't let your happiness and your peace and your confidence come and be dependent on other things, period. And a lot of what I saw, I'm gonna change this song in a second, when I was out there were people that were like, you know, how can I be like that blogger? How can I do what they're doing to get that body? Or how can I, you know, I like what she does for her blog. I just want to find her tips so I can get that audience and be doing what she's doing. Why would you want to do that? Why would you want to live somebody else's life? It's one thing to look up to somebody and respect them for what they've done. But when you are actually like saying, I have to be like that person, and you're insecure, we're all insecure. But the more that you can realize, like, I don't need to be insecure. I'm a great person. I have something, I was made the way I am. I'm individual, there's no one else like me. And I have talents that other people don't have. Embrace that and be who you are instead of thinking that, you know, again, you've got to follow that crowd or this crowd or whatever. I mean, this is like high school stuff, people, and there are grown adults that are out there. I'm gonna have to change the channel. I don't want to listen to this song. Grown adults out there that are, I mean, I kind of look at them and go, have you, like, not graduated from high school yet? Go back, figure this stuff out, and start understanding what it should be like to be a mature, grown, responsible adult. Be yourself. Take responsibility for who you are in your own life and stop, you know, stop making everything dependent on outside sources. Your whole life will change if you can finally realize that real happiness should happen wherever you are, whatever you have, however much you're earning, period. It doesn't depend on another person. It's a choice. It's a choice if I walk outside today and say, you know, wow, it's a beautiful day. It's nice, it's not humid, or if I walk out and go, God, it's so cold out. I can't believe it's not, you know, sunny out, or why isn't it more hot? I can't believe I don't live here. It's a choice. It's a choice how my attitude is going to be when I walk outside. It's a choice how I'm going to decide to wake up and view my surroundings. It's a choice to be happy regardless of what I have in my life and to be thankful for what I have and not focus on what I don't have. People, come on. Hold on, I gotta change the music. See, I'm thankful that I have music I can change. Hold on. Oh, I like this song. So, anyway, that was just a little side digression. But I'm quite enjoying my coffee. So, a couple of things. Had a really great week out in Portland, although I'm going to tell you, I'm a little confused by Portland. That's all I'm going to say. Not going to go into details because if I make observations about a city, I get people ripping on me. Very defensive. Just interesting. Pardon me. Country. But anyway, I kicked ass the entire week while I was out there. I think I worked out every day. There was maybe one night, Friday night? Not quite sure. I worked out two times every day. Was eating. I ate on my game the whole time. The only thing I probably didn't, that wasn't really totally what I would eat, is the, they made this steel-cut oats for breakfast. I'm just remembering the moment. It was so freaking good. But it had heavy cream, so had a little extra there. But I'm very excited to be back home. Let's see, Monday, worked out Monday. Today's Wednesday. Yesterday, I slept in, and then I had a meeting, and God, was that Monday or Tuesday? I'm sorry, the past 2 days are totally a blur for me. What was yesterday? I thought my meeting was on Monday. Is today Tuesday? I'm really having a moment here. I'm literally having an entire memory breakdown for you. At this moment, I'm telling you, I do not know if it's Tuesday or Wednesday. Actually, it's Tuesday. Okay. I'm not even lying. I thought it was Wednesday. Okay, so welcome to my life, people. Anyway, that's cool because it means it's earlier in the week and that means I have more this week to kick ass. Now, a couple of things. So, I'm back. I feel like we haven't had any sickness in a while, so it's time to really, I've been saying that for a while, but I honestly, guys, haven't been sick. So excited. Haven't been sick in a while, and I think that all of that, you know, whatever's in the past is in the past, and we're gonna leave it there. My dental work is, I'd say, 94% done. I have to go back and I have one more tooth that needs a cap, and then we're gonna do some whitening. And then we'll just move on to other areas. We're gonna start Botoxing and maybe some of this. Although apparently with this top, I don't really look like I need much, but looks are deceiving. There certainly is a lot in here that's gone away. I know you can't tell that right now because as I'm looking at myself, I look a lot more abundant than I am, or than I feel like I am. There's those blackbirds out there again. Hold on. Hey. Seriously? Ugh. Blackbirds are like such bullies. I don't like them. Oh, and then they come right back. Oh, that's not the blackbird. There's blackbirds that have like a red and yellow thing on their wings. They're something else. So a couple of things. I really believe that all that sickness is behind me. I'm ready to kick ass. I'm ready to hit the gym. New trainer. I'm going to be training with Jay down in Boca on a semi-regular basis, and then new trainer up here. Very excited about that. I will be doing some of my friends and I. Michelle, I don't know if Amy said she's going to do this or not. We are going to be doing that Ultimate Yogi DVD set for 108 days. So that's 108 days of solid yoga every. So you do yoga once a day, every day. And let me tell you, I did yoga cardio last night, and I think I've told you guys before, sometimes I feel like you have to do this high intensity cardio workout to get real sweaty. I did the yoga cardio, prevented myself from like doing a HIIT workout first to get the sweat going, and I kept looking down. I just had like a regular tank top on, and I just watched this sweat stain grow here, and then on the back, my whole back was literally just soaking. So it was intense, and I don't know what the deal is. I love that guy's style. I love that it's a class. I love that when I glance up and I look, I can see that everyone in the class is doing the poses differently, which is like a regular class. You know, when you're in a regular yoga class and, you know, you're not supposed to be looking at other people, but of course you're going to, by chance, look around. You'll see other people that are falling flat on their face where you're standing up straight and vice versa. You know, I can never get into, or I haven't been able to get into, usually at the end of workouts when they do frog pose. That's really difficult for me with my hips. But yet there's other things where I can do really well and I see a ton of people faltering. So we're all on our own, you know, journey, whatever. A couple of last things. I should call attention to this because I got this really, the reason I need to call attention to it is I'm going to eat the whole box. The folks from Bestowed sent me this box yesterday and I believe it's already 25% lighter. But it's one of these subscription boxes, but the difference is that Heather Bauer, who's a, forgive me if I'm saying this incorrectly, she's either a dietitian or a nutritionist, she picks out all the stuff that goes into it. So it's not just like, hey, whatever was randomly given to us. Hold on. Celebrity nutritionist Heather Bauer launches Bestow box. So, you know, this box will have, each box has a description. Yeah, it does. It comes with this, and then this is actually a little book. I haven't seen this. And trust me, at FitFluential, we see a lot of subscription services. I've never seen one that actually details what was in here. So this had, olives, Mediterranean olives, Z57, Matt's Munchies, premium fruit snacks, green and black dark chocolate, that's not in the box right now, I'll just let you mind wander there, sea snacks, roasted seaweed, I've heard a lot of people say they like this, I gotta try it, Nature's Bakery, all natural, raspberry fig bars, I ate that last night, I was having some hunger issues, Good Eating Salads by Paragon Books, I'm excited to read that actually, because you guys know about me and salads, this actually comes with a little book. I-Train, don't know what that is, but I'll figure it out. Manitoba Harvest Hemp Hearts, say that fast. Kind Dark Chocolate Chili Almond. Happy Family Happy Squeeze, that sounds like a Chinese restaurant. Hail Mary Vanilla Maple Almonds, Amy's Kitchen, Travel Tips, etc. So, I'm pretty impressed with this box, again, in my position. FitFluential, I see a lot of these subscription boxes, and some of them, you know, I looked at what they have, and it's literally like, are you really sending out samples of toothpaste? Like, it wasn't even like a Kind bar, not this, other ones. It would just be like, here's a taste of a Kind bar. It's kind of like, why would I pay for that? I mean, the whole point is to expose people to brands that they haven't been before, that are kind of ideal for what they're into. Why would you? That just makes no sense. Like, here's a grain of coffee. See how you'd like that. Why not just give somebody a cup of coffee? And that said, I'm at 13 minutes, so I've gone way over because I don't even know what day it is. And I will see you guys later. We'll talk more about the other stuff I was going to talk about in my next video. Happy almost 4th of July.